In this portion of the video, we will be covering vacuum testing. One of the number one things I want to cover is that if you've just done your positive pressure test, when you're about to do your vacuum test, you need to release your positive pressure from the system. You do not want to hook your vacuum up and then send your positive pressure to your vacuum. That's going to result in a bad day and a broken vacuum pump. So once your pressure is completely alleviated and your gauges are back down to zero, you need to grab your vacuum line, thread it onto your system, quick connect, whatever it may be, make sure the valve is open, and you can start your vacuum pump up. Once you've reached an ultimate vacuum per your altitude, and that can vary, you may not be able to reach a full 30, so just hop on Google and look what your elevation is and look what, you know, your ultimate vacuum possibilities are for your elevation. You may only reach negative 28 HG. Don't freak out, it's just the way that elevation and vacuum works. The next thing I want to address is once you have reached a complete vacuum, the steps to remove your vacuum from your system properly. You're going to want to shut the valve, and then there's going to be a little, should be on almost every vacuum pump, a secondary cap. There you can release, there we go, release the actual vacuum pressure that the pump is still pulling on this line with a closed valve. Then you can turn your vacuum pump off and then remove the vacuum pump from the system. That is the proper way to remove a vacuum pump from your extractor. Once your vacuum has been completely pulled, in all reality, you should have no issues holding a vacuum if you held positive pressure. That would be a very interesting scenario if you were able to hold positive pressure but not a vacuum on a stainless extractor. Once you've got a full vacuum held for 10 minutes or so, you know you're good to go and that your system is completely sealed.